Running is one of the most natural things in the world. From the time we're children, we crawl, we walk, and then we run. But of late, in the last few decades, recreational running has become a global phenomenon. In India alone, hundreds and thousands of people ran in marathon events last year. Those are huge numbers. But before we go there, let's start at the beginning. Today, I'm going to talk to a few coaches and a few runners on their journey from the time they started running. How did you become a coach?
Like after giving up running,
yeah.
I wanted to keep fit.
Yeah.
So I used to go to Priyarajani ground just to warm up and stretch and all and yeah. To run. There's other runners and all other coaches, they said, why don't you coach? So basically to keep myself fit, I started coaching the children. Most of the runners who want to run the marathon and all have never run before.
Yeah.
Even if they have run, it is during their school days and college days. And basically, like I can go to their level. Like, what I try to teach them is not in terms of the races or running the Bombay Marathon, to get them to enjoy running and get them back into running.
What reasons do they come? Do you ask them, why are you starting?
See, basically, I tell them, even if they are coming to run, they say like, oh, I want to run the Bombay Marathon.
Yeah.
I tell them, like, means I try to relax them. I tell them, see, forget the Bombay Marathon.
Yeah.
I know you will be able to run.
Yeah.
Because, but I want you all to run is to keep fit and to enjoy life.
Yeah.
Because if you are fit, you will enjoy life.
Correct.
So basically, it is that way. And I try to relax them. Mentally, I try to relax them so that they enjoy running.
Yeah.
And as they get fitter and fitter, then they start running better and better. What is the use of all the money in the world if you cannot enjoy it? If you want to enjoy life, you have to be fit. And to be fit, you have to exercise and run.
So Rohini, how long have you been running?
About 2 years.
How old are you, if you don't mind saying it on camera?
I'm 59.
You're 59. Okay, and you started
I
2 years ago?
57, yeah.
Were you into any kind of sport or exercise before that?
Yes, I have been a sports person throughout, let's put it this way. School, college. Then after that, around 32, 33, I picked up tennis.
Right.
I work, actually. I work in a bank.
Right.
And whenever I was posted, whenever an opportunity was there, I was playing tennis. But it was very off and on because the assignments were pretty stressed. Yeah.
So why did you feel like starting running?
It's pretty inspirational, and what would you say, it gives you a peace of mind, it gives you joy, actually.
Yes. Anyway, lovely, absolutely
thank you
amazing
so much,
to meet you. You're going to inspire thousands and thousands of women. How many years have you been running?
I've been running since 3 years now.
Only 3 years?
Yes, I started running in probably later part of 2010.
How old are you?
I'm 38.
In 3 years, you want to do 100 kilometers under 12 hours.
Tougher target, but let's see how things
go. Don't you think it's going too much too soon?
Not exactly. No. I've been into sports earlier, were doing short distances, 100, 200s earlier when I was in college.
School.
In school,
but
college.
But then for 15 years, you didn't do anything?
Yeah, I
20
was.
Years.
20 years? Rather, 20, yeah. 15 to 20 years, I was doing nothing.
So, do you think running has brought any change in your life?
Yes, absolutely.
Besides waking up early at 5
o'clock in the morning. No. I was weighing 85 kgs that time.
Wow.
Right, and I've reduced in my peak of my performance, rather I was 70. Right now I'm 72. So it brought a lot of fitness.
Yeah.
And fitness of mind, fitness of body.
Have you ever been injured?
No.
Never?
Never. Principally, I think you should listen to your body.
Mm.
Right. If your body says stop, you should stop. Mm. I think you should not push yourself to a certain limit where you actually collapse.
Whether you're mentally you can't do it or physically you can't do it.
Yes, absolutely.
So when mentally you can't do it, you have to fight that.
You have to fight that.
But when physically you can't do it, you should stop.
You should stop.
Otherwise, you will be injured.
You will be injured. So I take breaks in probably a training of 4-5 months. I take a break of a week or so.
Excellent. Thank you, Sukhjeevan.
Thank you.
All the best for your 100
kilometers. Thank you. Bye. Run and be happy. What are you waiting for?